You pushed and lobbied very heavily to get this through. What was your, were you pleased with the outcome of this? And what do you say to critics who say, you know what, it's really not a good idea to mix liquor and guns at bars?
Well, first off, I appreciate having you here. Thank you for having me here. That is something that's already allowed in the state of Georgia. Presently, under current law, you can go into a bar if you have permission from the owner. The only thing that changes is you don't have to have permission to go in there anymore. That's been the law for the last 4 years, and we have not had massive shootouts and everything that everybody claims that we're going to have. And that's really a minor change in this law. Plus the fact that the private property owner still has a right to deny you access to his property.
If you're carrying a gun.
For any reason, but yes, if you're carrying a gun, but a private property owner can deny you access to his property regardless.
You know, Robyn, you've been pretty proactive in terms of trying to prevent more widespread ability for people to carry guns in this country. What concerns you most about this new law that Georgia is enacting?
Well, thanks for having me on. And I think when you look at this bill, what's important, I think, is to take a step back and look at it in context. So you have all of these permit holders. Georgia doesn't require any firearm safety training to have a permit. So now you have hundreds of thousands of permit holders who can take guns in all kinds of places, churches, bars, schools, which creates a risk of having so many guns in so many places. And then on top of that, the bill disempowers law enforcement from checking to make sure that people do have permits, valid permits, who have guns, unless they have other reasons to check that person. The other thing it does is it expands its stand your ground laws. So now somebody who even has a gun without a permit, who uses it in self-defense and claims stand your ground, is going to be able to use that defense. So you take this expansion of places you can have guns, like bars, like churches, you include the expansion of stand your ground protection, and now you restrict law enforcement. You're creating a situation where there's more risk, there's more danger, you're putting more people in harm's way unnecessarily.
I mean, and that's really the concern here, Jerry. I mean, the more people that carry guns, the more chance you have of being in a pretty unpleasant situation where one of those guns goes off. And that's fundamentally what people are worried about. What do you respond to that criticism with?
Well, we hear that every time we get we obtain more of our freedoms back. But the thing is, that never happens. Every time it happens, the place gets safer. The crime statistics go down. And as far as training, there are no studies that show that there are any more accidents for states that require training that do not require training.
Robyn, it seems to me that logically, the more guns you have in a society, the more risk you're putting into society.
Absolutely. When you look at the numbers and you look at states that have very weak gun regulations versus the states that have very strong gun regulations, New York or California or Massachusetts, you can see very clearly that states like Georgia that have weak gun regulations have much higher rates of gun violence and gun death than states with stronger regulations. So if you want to just look purely at the numbers show that weakening gun regulations, having more guns in our public places, doesn't actually make you safer in reality. You might feel safer because you think you have a gun on you and that makes you safer, but in truth, it doesn't make our community safer, and it certainly doesn't make the state any safer.
Let me ask you, Robyn, just, you know, we've seen examples of how the business community has come together and really been able to enact or basically rally people against particular bills that have been presented. You think about Arizona and the discrimination bill there that would have, you know, allowed people not to serve gays in Arizona. When you look at Atlanta and you think of the big companies that are there, don't you think that big companies in some way might be concerned if now you know, you're allowed to bring guns onto the premises?
I would hope so. I mean, I think any rational, reasonable owner of a business is going to understand the risk presented by having more guns in their place of business. And thankfully, this bill at least still allows churches to have to opt in to have guns and bars to be able to, in some circumstances, opt out. So there are some limited ways in which you can prevent guns from being on your premises. But ideally, what you'd have at best is places where you can go and you know that you're safe from from guns. And I think it's sort of a sad situation that we're in there.
Jerry, really quickly, have you seen much pushback yet from the business community? I mean, I know that the Restaurant Association was very concerned about this. They didn't like the idea of people being able to bring guns into bars, and it places a lot more risk onto an actual bar owner.
Well, they've always been against every provision that we've put into law. First off, as far as the companies go, it's still private property. They can deny you the right to go on to company property. Anybody's private property.
Okay.
And as far as the number of guns making it more dangerous, apparently Robyn has not read about what happened in Chicago last weekend. And if you look at Chicago and Washington, D.C., who have some of the strongest gun laws in the nation, they have the highest crime rates and the highest murder rates of anybody in the country.
Right.
I don't understand how...
Thank you so much, Jerry.
Briefly,
go ahead, Robyn.
I'd love to just briefly respond to that by saying it's really unfortunate that cities like Washington and Chicago can't actually enforce the level of gun regulation they would like, because we have porous borders in this country and we have surrounding states that have such weak gun laws that even with the best efforts of cities like Washington, D.C. and Chicago, and New York City is a great example too, you have guns flowing in from states like Georgia that have weak gun laws, and so guns get trafficked out of those states into states with stronger laws. So I think it's just such a misdirection to point to that as a reason why we shouldn't have stronger laws
across
the country.
Yeah, and it's pretty amazing.